friends, I'm your English teacher Shabana, and today I will teach you a poem that is Wagcut and Fish. Okay, students, do you know about fishermen? Yes. How fishermen work and how they live and what his life is like. Okay, I will tell you. They work very hard to keep their boats and nets in good condition. Sometimes they face storm out fishing for days. Okay, students, they start their days even before the sun rises and go into the sea in their fishing boats. Okay, so students, now we will read the chapter and we will know about the fishermen, how they work hard for their life. Okay, students, let's read.
Now, students, we will read the poem Wagcut and Fish. Now let's begin. Fishermen work hard every day to catch fish to sell in the market. They bring some of their catch home to feed the family. Imagine what would happen if the fish could talk and request the fishermen not to cook or sell them. Just read the poem and find out what happened over there. Okay, students, yes, do you know about the life of a fisherman? Because this poem is about a fisherman, hai na? Yes, yes. Now, you have to just close your eyes and imagine you are with Wagcut in his boat. Okay, students, yes. Just imagine you sail into the sea in his boat and it's very early in the morning and you are still very sleepy and trying not to yawn. Okay, student, just imagine ki aap boat mein ho and you are very sleepy because it was very early time of the morning. That's why you are still very sleepy and trying not to yawn. You peer into the sea to check if it is the perfect spot to catch fish. Then you cast your net and wait and wait and wait till sunset to catch fish. Yes, students, after that, suddenly you catch a big fish and you are happy on that time. You think now you can make a tasty fish dish for dinner. You are in the market then, buying a coconut because you want to cook the fish in coconut milk gravy. Yummy! Then you are back in your hut and are about to cook the fish when the fish starts crying. Yes, just imagine, student, if you catch the fish and you want to eat that fish, on that time that fish started crying. Okay, students, he is pointing at the frying pan and requesting not to put me in this pan as he doesn't want to be cooked. He looks very scared on the time. The fisherman looks very scared and is begging with folded fins to let him live. Your heart melts. Hai na? You decided to keep the fish as your pet. You are putting a collar around the fish neck with a leash. You have made a special water tub for the fish and you and the fish are happily strolling in the village. What a funny sight it is. Is it? What a funny sight it is, no? Yes, student. This story, the end of this poem is very funny. So, now let's read the poem. Okay, let's read. Wagcut the fisherman sailed his boat at dawn, peered into Arabian Sea, trying not to yawn. Yes, students, there are two words. They are rhymed together, dawn and yawn. Dawn, yawn. Dawn, yawn. Fisherman Wagcut is very hardworking. Hai na? Venkat fisherman was very hard working. He sailed his boat at dawn. Dawn means early morning. Dawn means early morning. Like when you get up, that is the time of dawn. Okay. Venkat the fisherman sailed his boat at dawn, peered into Arabian Sea, trying not to yawn. Means I told you that Venkat the fisherman sailed his boat at the early time of the morning, and he goes in the Arabian Sea, hai na? He goes into the Arabian Sea, and that trying not to yawn because the time was very earlier in the morning. That's why he is not trying to yawn. Okay, students. Yes, Venkat the fisherman cast his sturdy net into the deep blue sea and waited till sunset. Venkat the fisherman cast his sturdy net. Cast his sturdy net. Sturdy means strong and cannot be broken easily. That is very strong. And a sturdy means very strong. And cast means throw something forcefully into the water to catch a fish. ये स्टूडेंट्स, आपने देखा होगा कि जो फिशरमैन होता है वो अपने नेट को पानी में फिशिंग करने के लिए थ्रो करता है. दैट इज़ द कास्ट. ओके, दैट इज़ द वर्ड कास्ट. कास्ट मीनिंग थ्रो समथिंग फोर्सफुली इनटू द वाटर टू कैच अ फिश. कास्ट कास्ट हिज स्टर्डी नेट इनटू द डीप ब्लू सी एंड वेटेड टिल सनसेट. आफ्टर कास्टिंग हिज स्टर्डी नेट इन द डीप ब्लू सी He was waiting till sunset. Venkat the fisherman caught a big fish. After some time, yes students, after some time, Venkat the fisherman caught a big fish. He thought he will make a nice spicy fish dish. On that time, Venkat the fisherman thought, After catching a big fish, he thought he will make a nice spicy fish dish. कि वो fish की dish बनाएगा. Okay? But Venkat the fisherman came back to his hut. Venkat the fisherman came back to his hut to make his tasty fish curry. He bought a fresh coconut to make his curry very tasty. He bought a fresh coconut, and after buying a fresh coconut, he saw that the fish was begging. The fish was requesting to leave her. Okay, students, now we will read again. Venkat the fisherman got ready to cook fish. Venkat the fisherman got ready to cook fish. But the whole ant said, Please don't be so selfish. Whole means to make a loud sound to express pain and sadness. Because on that time the fish was requesting to Venkat that please leave me, not to cook me, and said please don't be so selfish. Ki selfish mat ho jao. Selfish means a person who doesn't care for others. Selfish means who doesn't care for others. Venkat the fisherman got ready to cook fish. When Venkat get ready to cook fish, on that time fish requesting and begging for his life, for her life, and said, please don't be so selfish. Ki selfish mat ho, zyada swarthi mat ho. I want to live. Oh Venkat, आई वॉन्ट टू लिव, मैं जीना चाहती हूँ. ओ वेंकट आई वॉन्ट टू लिव. इफ यू बी काइंड टू मी आई विल ऑलवेज कीप यू इंटरटेन फॉर फ्री. अगर तुम मुझे छोड़ दोगे, शी सैड, अगर तुम मुझे छोड़ दोगे तो मैं तुम्हारे लिए तुम्हें हमेशा इंटरटेन करूँगी. मुझे आज़ाद करने के लिए, फ्री करने के लिए ऑलवेज इंटरटेन करूँगी. आई वॉन्ट टू लिव ओ वेंकट, इफ़ यू बी काइंड टू मी आई विल ऑलवेज कीप यू इंटरटेन फॉर फ्री. ओके यस स्टूडेंट्स, देर आर सम राइमिंग वर्ड्स ओवर देयर, सो यू हैव टू रिकोगनाइज द राइमिंग वर्ड्स ऑल्सो. ओके, फ्री एंड मी, मी फ्री, there are rhyming words. Yes students, I want to live, oh Vankar, if you be kind to me I will always keep you entertained for free. अगर तुम मुझे छोड़ दोगे, अगर तुम मुझे मेरे साथ काइंड हो जाओगे, मुझे नहीं पकाओगे, then I will always keep you entertained for free. I will swim no more. Yes students, I will, who said? Fish said, I will swim no more, oh Vankar. She expresses pain and said, I will swim no more. मैं और नहीं तैर पाऊंगी. I will swim no more, oh Vankar. If you put me in frying pan, let me swish. Don't make me a dish. Be a good, gentle fisherman. Fish expresses her pain and said, I will swim no more, oh Vankar, if you put me in frying pan, agar tum mujhe frying pan mein rakh doge, agar tum mujhe paka doge, cook kar doge, let me swish. Swish means move with rushing sound, especially in water. Okay, let me swish. Don't make me a dish. Let me swish ki mujhe pani mein dal do, pani mein jaane do, let me swish. Don't make me a dish. मुझे dish मत बनाओ. Be a good gentle fisherman. Be a good gentle fisherman. Please, एक अच्छे good gentle fisherman बन जाओ. Hearing this, Vankat stopped. Hearing this, Vankat stopped. And he got mighty upset. Because on that time, the fish expresses her sadness, expresses her pain because she want to live, but the fisherman Vankat want to eat it. Hai na? Fisherman Vankat want to eat it and fish want to live. And she said, let me swish, don't make me a fish. Be a good gentle fisherman. Hearing this, Vankat stopped. He got mighty upset, extremely unhappy. Mighty upset, extremely unhappy. On that time, he was very unhappy because he did not anything to eat on that time. And fish was begging. And the fish sure is happy and safe because now it's Vankat's pet. After that, Vankat made her as a pet. Okay, Vankat made her, Vankat have made a special water tub for the fish and the fish are happy strolling. Fish is happy strolling in the village because after that, it was Vankat's pet. Okay students, the poem has finished and now you have to find out rhyming words. Do you know about rhyming words? What are rhyming words? Yes students, rhyming words. Yes, rhyming words, they are in rhythm. Because poets often use rhyming words to create a rhythm or a musical effect. Hai na? Yes. Now you have to find out some rhyming words from the story and write them in your notebook. Okay students, bye bye, stay home and keep safe.